All right, this video is going to cover the WAGO I/O Pro CAA programming guide and creating a function block. We're going to be programming a average function, and what this is going to do is going to pass an array of values and give you the average or the mean result. And this PDF document, you can see, steps you through very easily through the creation of this program. And we're also going to be covering how to create a visualization that allow you to manipulate the variables through a visualization interface. All right, we're ready to start programming Codasys. Go ahead and click on File, New, and we're going to program a 750-841. On the Visualizations tab, I want to enable web visualizations and click OK. And our default PLC-PRG is going to be a ladder diagram. Just want to right click on the white area under POUs, and I'm going to add an object. It's going to be a function of type integer. I program that in structured text. Then name that average. At this point, we can start programming our function. So as you start entering your code, you'll notice it'll ask you to declare your variables. Variable num is actually an input variable that we're going to pass into our function, and it is an integer. And next, we need to do our for loop. Just going to count the contents of our array. Index is a local variable. It's an integer. Sum is also a local variable, and it's an integer. And the values is actually a variable input. And this is going to be an array. Of integers. So again, this is just going to create a loop, and the loop will basically operate from 1 to whatever the value of num is, so for however many variables that we'd like to average. And each time it runs through this, it's going to increment sum based on the, it's going to totalize the contents of all of the containers that are included in this array. At this point, we have a sum total of all of the values that we've sent into this function block. And now we can create an average based on that. So the average is the sum divided by the number of elements. Notice average is not shown up here as a variable. It's actually the return variable for our function. We can set up an else statement, and we're just going to return a minus 1 if our num is 0. And put a comment here. All right, that's our function. Go back to our PLC-PRG. Set up an array for our example here. 100 elements of integers. And set up a variable to accept our mean. And at this point, we can insert a box. We're going to change this to our average. And you can see here it populated the inputs that we're looking for. So our values are tied to my values. And for num, I'm just going to put a constant here of 5. And we'll tie this to mean. And again, for all these, we can use the input assistant. If we didn't remember that we had mean there, you can press F2 and go to the input assistant and select the variable that you're looking for. Alright, at this point we can go to the Visualizations tab. And we'll create a new visualization. And we'll call that average. I'm just going to select the square input box. And we're going to go to text. And I'm going to type in value percent s. And this percent little s is a identifies a variable display. So go to variables and text display. And you can see here, as soon as you type in plc underscore prg period, it'll prompt you with the inputs to display here. I'm going to select my values. And I'm going to use the brackets to indicate the first input that variable, and I'm just going to cut and paste this a few times. I'm going in each one of these and change the array reference. All right, and the final box. Will be the mean. And you can also change the colors on these objects if you want to. It's totally up to you. All right, at this point we're going to build the project. We have no errors and no warnings. We can go into simulation mode and log in. And I just want to enter some numbers here. And we're going to run the processor. And here you can see our average is being displayed, average of 4. And I can change these numbers and it automatically will update the result.